A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18th June, on the front page you have West Bengal doctors withdraw strike. So in an unprecedented televised meeting, CM Mamata Banerjee of West Bengal assured doctors of increased security. So Indian Medical Association had also called for a nationwide strike as such yesterday. So all non-essential services were stopped. Then this is PM asks opposition to speak out on issues. So don't bother about your numbers is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi tells the opposition. Speak out on issues. Then 10 injured as militants trigger IED blast again in Pulwama. So now militants have triggered again an intensive explosive device blast in the Pulwama region in Jammu and Kashmir. So army personnel traveling in a mine-proof vehicle was targeted. And below you have Iran to breach uranium stockpile limit. So Iran is said to be surpassing the June 27 its uranium stockpile limit set under the nuclear deal, the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action. So USA has opted out of the deal and now Iran is also going beyond the provisions. So you can see the 300 kg reserve of enriched uranium, that countdown to pass that has started, and in 10 days time it is seen that Iran would pass that limit. So enriched uranium is required for making weapons, bombs, and low enriched uranium, LEU, is required for peaceful use of nuclear energy, that is for atomic reactors. Then on page 2 you have below, Supreme Court seeks centers stand on petitions by trainee IAS IPS officers. So Supreme Court has sought the central government stand on the petitions. The IAS IPS officers group of the 2018 batch, they're seeking another chance to exercise KW preference in parity with 20 other colleagues who were granted relief by the apex court in last month. So Supreme Court has asked the central government as such, on these 20 IAS IPS officers, there was relief given to them. They had challenged the government's cadre allocation process, and the Supreme Court ruled that for each of them, one post each in the state cadres of their preference should be increased to accommodate their demands. So now the another batch, another group of trainee IAS IPS officers are seeking relief from the Supreme Court. The case had gone before the High Court. The High Court had ruled in favor of the IAS IPS officers. And then the center moved the Supreme Court. On page 4, you have this coverage on waste management, that what is kitchen waste, garden waste, which goes in green bin. Blue bin is for plastic, paper and metal and other dry waste. So that is shown here. Waste segregation at source, it is said, is the key. So this is an important coverage. On page 9, you have Vayu no longer a cyclone to cross as low pressure. So cyclone Vayu has dissipated now earlier than expected, and it will not make a landfall over Gujarat. So however, the system is expected to bring in rains and wind. And this is acute encephalitis syndrome toll in Muzaffarpur in Bihar hits 104. So Bihar schools will remain shut till June 24 as heat waves separately have claimed 90 lives. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Gloves Off on Trade. So this talks of India-US trade relations. It says, as India finally imposes retaliatory tariff on US goods, flexibility should inform policy. So it should not be a fight, but there should be flexibility in dealing with the matter. And this is the Litchi link. So this is regarding the acute encephalitis syndrome cases is in Muzaffarpur district of Bihar. So a huge number of children have died. So earlier two such cases came forth last year. So in Bihar, authorities have failed at several levels to prevent death due to encephalitis. And the Litchi link was seen last year too. So you can see in 2017 too, there was this incident of encephalitis. And it was confirmed by even an American Indo-US team that the litchi fruit was responsible for the mysterious deaths. Those children who did not have dinner and slept, you know, without eating a meal. So you can see it, the recommended prevention strategy is making sure no child goes to bed without eating a meal. So, and then they, when they consume this litchi, it had, it is said this has this toxin, which is MCPG. So which is also known as hypoglycin A, which resulted in the death of the children. Then the lead article is a blinkered understanding of migration. So this is regarding the draft Emigration Bill 2019 of India. So this is not the Emigration Bill of Hong Kong. So this bill, it says, is more about managing the export of human resources than being a humanitarian framework. So it talks about the features of this bill, how, you know, what it tries to achieve. So how, you know, we export human resource to other countries. So that is it. And below you have serious concerns over BT brinjal. So this article says there is no evidence that GM, genetically modified brinjal, will benefit farmers. So there are concerns over it. We had seen recently news of BT brinjal being illegally sown in farms. So it has not been given, you know, approval for commercial cultivation. Only trials have been allowed, but it seems commercial cultivation was taking place in this one farm. So this article talks of how BT brinjal has no benefit for farmers. Then on the op-ed page you have the danger of territorial nationalism. So this article says the opposition has not done enough to defend India's inclusive and plural ethos. So nationalism, which tries to paint everything in one color, how, what are the dangers of it, are discussed in this article. And then this is unleashing the potential of urban India. So this talks about how India could learn from UK's model of city deals. So you should know about UK, which has rolled out city deals, which is an agreement between central government and the city's economic region. So it's a competition policy style approach. So the city is an economic region as such, which is represented by combined authority and statutory bodies are established. So it brings in, you know, reforms as such, and performance is improved of cities. Then this is across sectors over time. So it says policies should be directed towards long-term sustainable development goals rather than short-term growth. On page 13, you have Supreme Court to hear plea on doctor's safety. So petition has been filed seeking uniform security personnel in all government hospitals. So Supreme Court will hear this case now. And this is India to host UN meet on land degradation in September. So 5,000 delegates from nearly 197 countries will take part at the 14th session of COP, that is Conference of Parties of UN Convention on to Combat Desertification, which will take place in September 2019 in Delhi. Then on international page you have Germany, UK warn Iran against reneging on deal. So EU has dismissed threats by Iran too. So this was the front page news, which we saw how Iran is going to breach its limit for enriched uranium, the 300 kg limit set in the nuclear deal. So this is regarding that how the European countries and European Union as such are warning Iran against violating the deal. And here you have 30 killed in Northeast Nigeria suicide attack. So three bombers took part in the incident in which at least 30 people have been killed. It was a triple suicide attack. So it has been claimed by Islamic State, the Boko Haram group and its Islamic State splinter group. And this is Sri Lanka misusing UN law activists. So media activists have accused Sri Lankan police of using a UN convention on hate speeches to crack down on media freedom and the country's Muslim minority. So this is Free Media Movement Rights Group, which has said that a special task force has attempted to arrest a respected journalist for his writing on anti-Muslim riots and Buddhist extremism. So there is this International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. So, so it is said that action is being taken against media personnel under this international convention. Then there is no important news on business page. This also will take place for the public sector banks. Here you have Department of Telecom panel approves levy of penalty on Airtel Vodafone Idea. So it has asked TRAI, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, to review this 3050 crore fine amount over denial of interconnection to Jio. So this was an old issue. So still, you know, approval finally has come from Department of Telecom too. And this is India to actively curb conflict diamonds. So India hosted first ever Kimberley meet, and it has committed to play an active role to curb circulation of conflict diamonds of blood or blood diamonds in the international market. So these are diamonds which are mined in regions where you know, human rights violation takes place, people are exploited. Then on the last page you have Bitcoin's use causing huge carbon dioxide emissions, says study. So the use of cryptocurrency Bitcoin emits 22 megatons of carbon dioxide annually, comparable to emissions of cities such as Las Vegas and Vienna, is what the study claims. And below you have EU leaders to debate push for zero emissions. So the European Union leaders will meet this week to discuss the target of zero net greenhouse gas emissions by 2050. So that is what European Union leaders target. So discussions would take place on this. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. So there is a separate course for full current affairs videos which can be availed from there. Thank you.